Hello and welcome back to my channel. Thank you for clicking on my video. Today I grabbed one of the newest palettes in my collection, and that is the Exotic Peacock from Pinky Rose Cosmetics. This is a really beautiful palette with a very, very pretty color story. It can be a little bit scary, but I had so much fun creating this look. This is the second time I've used this palette, but the first time that I've used it exclusively to make a look. So if you want to see how I did this look using this palette, then don't go anywhere. And if you're new to my channel, hello and welcome. My name is Rachel. I am a homeschooling stay-at-home mom who loves to play with colorful eyeshadow. I don't know much about other kinds of makeup. For me, it's all about the eyes. So if you're interested in seeing lots of colorful content on your timeline, from tutorials to rankings and declutters and YouTuber tags, anything like that, I hope you'll consider liking and subscribing. I do try to upload about 3 videos a week, and you can also find me on Instagram at Shimmers and Silver, and under the Reels tab on Instagram, there are mini tutorials that don't make it to YouTube. So, without talking anymore, let's get into this eye look and see what I think about the palette. Okay, so this is now my second time using this palette, but my first time using it for, using it exclusively for a look. And I've done a lot of green looks lately. I've definitely been on a green kick, and I think today I want to avoid the green because I want to push myself into a different color story. So I think I'm going to do like a blue-purple. And again, because I haven't used this palette, I've only used 2 shades, I'm not sure how everything's going to perform. Particularly the shimmers, I've never used the shimmers in this palette, but I have high expectations because the 2 shades that I did use performed very well. So let's just dive right in and see what happens. I'm going to start by taking a small blending or pencil brush, and I'm going to dip into the shade Lovesick, which in the pan it looks like a light aqua. And I'm going to put that on my inner crease. Yeah, it's a light aqua. It's pretty. To be totally transparent, this look is very heavily inspired by a look that Angelica Nyquist did, but I think I might change a little bit. Hers was more heavy on the dark blues, and dark blue, like I really like blue eyeshadow, but dark blue on me can make me look kind of tired, so I'm just going to be really careful with how much of that color I apply and how far I bring it over. I might change things slightly to match my skin tones a little bit better. I'll blend that more in a minute, but now I'm going to take a larger and more dense blending brush. I'm going to grab the shade Truth, and I'm not going to go in super heavy with this shade, especially because I feel like it's going to be really pigmented. I'm placing Truth in the outer corner and up into the crease and blending it towards the Lovesick shade that I laid down. I'm just really excited to play with this palette. It's funny because I can understand why this palette is intimidating. These are kind of a collection of all the colors that are intimidating to people or frightening to people. You know, blue eyeshadow, bright purple eyeshadow, green eyeshadow, weird yellowy brownish sorts of colors, a hot pink. It's not in any way a neutral palette. It's not a very safe palette if you're not quite comfortable with color. I'm not complaining. This is my kind of color story right here, which is why I bought it and why I'm excited to play with it. But if you're not comfortable with color, I could understand how this would be a little bit scary. Truthfully, I'm intimidated by the Hummingbird palette from Udensai. I love that palette, but it is a little bit scary because it's just so bold. There's nothing safe about it. So you really have to just commit to what you're doing. And I feel like that's how this palette is too. It's go big or choose a different palette. Where these two colors meet, I kind of ended the aqua here and let it fade, and now I'm ending the Truth shade here and letting it fade, and then I'm gonna just take a small blending brush and work them together because they could easily become really muddy. So back to that original blending brush, and I'm just very, very lightly working the shades together. Angelica, when she did this, she has yellow undertones for her skin, and blues really pop on her skin in a very flattering way. I have blue undertones, and so that doesn't mean that I can't wear blue, it just means I have to be careful. Much more careful, I think, about the colors and the shades that I use. Bright blues look much better on me than dark blues. which is why I'm being very careful with this truth shade. And now to work these blues together a little bit better and keep it on the lighter side of things, I am going back in with that same small blending brush, going back into the shade Lovesick. And I would rather it be more aqua heavy than more dark blue heavy. So I'm taking Lovesick and accidentally placing it on top of my eyebrow. I'm taking Lovesick and going, I'm touching where I finished it, like where I ended it, and just very lightly blending it in to the dark blue. So I'm carrying the light over to the dark, which keeps me from overpowering the light by carrying the dark over onto the light. All right, I'm gonna take a larger blending brush and just soften out these edges right here. I'm now gonna take a small blending brush and dip into the dark purple matte. It's called Lustful. I have to say I'm not a huge fan of these shade names. They have nothing to do with peacocks. It's just random. I'm gonna put Lustful right in the outer corner to kind of purple up that blue a little bit. I don't want to totally cover the blue. I do want a little bit of blue peeking out, so this is staying very much in the outer corner. I'm not having any problem with these shadows or anything yet. So far, they're all very, very pigmented. They've been easy to work with and blendable, and they're buildable, clearly, because I've now got the third color, or the second color around in this area. And I haven't had any patchiness either. So everything's working really nicely. And then I'll go back into that denser blending brush that I used to place down the blue matte, and I'm just gonna tap this over that area just to help blend those two colors together. I'm gonna clean up under my lower lash line, put a little bit of concealer there because I have a bit of green residue like left over from yesterday's look. Just wanna clean that area up. I do not want green to sneak into this look. And that could easily happen between brushes that haven't been properly cleaned and whatever might be left over on the waterline or anything. So I'm going to tidy that up with some concealer, then I'll be back and we'll move and do some colors on the lower lash line. Okay, now I wanna put some color on the lower lash line. I'm gonna take a smudger brush. I like using the smudger brush because it gives me a little bit more dense precision. I used to use small blending brushes, but they, unless I'm doing something smokier, they blow out the color a bit more, and I want the color to stay in a tighter area. So this is a smudger brush, and this is where I'm gonna carry in the purple. So I'm gonna dip back into the Lustful shade, that dark purple matte, and put that on my lower outer corner. Okay, now I'm gonna stop for the lower lash line for now. I'm gonna take a small flat or C or shader brush, whatever you wanna call it. I'm gonna dip into the shade Peacock, which is the light blue shimmer. I don't know if I should spray these shimmers because I've never used a pinky rose shimmer before, so I'm gonna place it down just out of curiosity. I wanna see how it performs dry. I'm gonna use it dry first. I suspect I'm gonna spray it, but we'll find out. So Peacock is on my brush. I'm starting in the inner corner. Okay, that's not bad. I'm gonna try it wet though. I wanna see how it performs if you spray it. Just so you know, I always spray my brush with setting spray, but you can also spray it with water and it usually has the same result. It's just a matter of moistening the product. It helps it apply with a little bit more of a high shine or a metallic sort of quality. So my brush is sprayed and now I'm gonna try it. Yeah, that's better. See, it's a little bit easier to apply. It's more like painting on because it's less powdery and more, and it's been moistened, but it also has a bit of a higher shine, a little more metallic. And so I'm carrying that shade on the entire lid space towards those darker blues in the outer corner. I like it when my colors are at an angle, and so I'm carrying the top part of the color further than the bottom part. In case you've noticed, I don't really do the cat eye shape so much as I used to, where I would wing out the shadow itself in the outer corner. Now I've been rounding it off more, which I do like. I prefer that eye shape. I feel like before, when I had a very distinct outer corner of shadow, I'm not talking about wings from like an eyeliner, but a shadow wing, the way that I was doing it tended to make it look kind of like I was wearing a superhero mask, you know, with a very clear line. And I don't want that. I want I want it a little bit more round and soft, and then I can add that definition with a winged liner, but that's a different feel. You know what I mean? So, I prefer to have my colors laid out in an angle like this, but not so much winging out the shadow at an angle. I don't know if that makes sense. It's quite early in the morning and I got only about 4 hours of sleep, so if I don't make sense, that's why. So this peacock shade is going all the way to meet those blues. I would say this shimmer reminds me of ColourPop shimmers. It's a little bit more powdery, less creamy. It doesn't have the impact of, say, an Udenzai or a Melt shimmer, but it's quite nice. And then I'm taking that same brush and I'm gonna grab the dark blue shimmer called Enchanted, and I'm gonna go in pretty lightly with this one, and I'm gonna spray it because the peacock shimmer did perform better when sprayed. And I'm gonna place this where the light shimmer meets the dark matte and just blend them together. I think that's looking quite pretty. And now if I wanted to blend them any more, I would dip back into the light blue shimmer and blend out onto the dark, again for the same reason that I used the light blue matte to blend into the dark blue matte, because I want the light to be more prominent and not get overpowered. So I would take the light color and blend out the darker color with it. But I actually think that this is quite a nice blend, and I'm not going to touch it anymore. Okay, so now how this look is differing from Angelica's is very subtle. She had a lot more purple on the upper lash line and the outer corner, and then what she did next was she carried the purple shimmer into this outer corner. Then she took the color Discreet, which is a very green-leaning teal, and she put that right here in the inner corner. I did really like the way that she and like her final look was. It was very peacocky and very pretty. But I also kind of want to use the yellow shimmer, and I don't know what to do. Maybe I'll do what she did, but then I'll put a pop of yellow as the inner corner. I think I'll start by adding in a little more purple on the upper on the upper lid. So I'm taking that denser blending brush, dipping back into the shade Lustful, and just tapping a bit more purple in there. I will continue in with the purple shimmer as she did. I'm taking a small pencil brush for this and dipping into the shade Tease, which is a purple shimmer, and then I'm going to spray my brush. And I'm going to lay Tease on top of the Lustful shade that we put down here. Alright, so this is what I decided to do. I put that purple shimmer, and now I take a little bit of Discreet, just a little bit, which is that dark green-leaning teal matte, and I'm going to put it right where the purple ends, kind of under the center of my eye, but I'm not bringing it all the way up in, because this shade on me is quite dark as an inner corner highlight shade. Again, Angelica has yellow undertones in her skin, so the colors will pop on her in a different way. I do really like this shade, and I like the element that it brings into the look, but I don't want to make myself look tired. And there's already a high risk of that by using these dark purpley blues. So I'm putting Discreet just in the center of my lower lash line. And then I'm going to take an even smaller pencil brush and grab the shade Erotic, which is the yellow shimmer. This is not, I kind of wish it were like a lemon yellow. I have lemon yellows in other palettes I could easily grab, but I want to stay in this palette for the purposes of today's video. So I'm just grabbing that shimmer and I'm gonna dip into the pan and then spray my brush. And now this I want to put as the inner corner highlight, so I'm putting that right up here and carry it down to meet Discreet. I do really wish that this were a more bright yellow shimmer in this palette. This one's more of a grungy gold sort of yellow, and it does work with all the shades within the palette, but I think that a yellow, like a lemon yellow shimmer, would have brought a lot more brightness and oomph to complement the rest of these shadows. Anyway, this is pretty much the eye look. I'm going to finish up the other side and throw on some black eyeliner. In my waterline, what will I do in my waterline? In my waterline, I think I'm probably just going to use a white. I could use blue, I could use purple, I could use green. But I think I'll just use white because I think that might help accentuate all the colors that I've got on the lower lash line. And then I'll be back to show you the finished look. All right, everyone, and here's the finished look. I put on some black eyeliner, a mascara, a little bit of face product, and a ColourPop lip oil. I think that this look is really pretty. I love the blue and purple combination. It is one of my favorite color combinations. I love blue and purple, blue and green, yellow and green, red and pink. They're all just, they just make me smile. And I think that this look turned out quite pretty. So my final thoughts on the palette. I think that the palette is very beautiful. I love the color story. I have had no issues at all with the formula. Everything blended nicely, everything built quite nicely, which sometimes you get patchiness with building, especially in dark mattes. And these dark mattes applied and built very, very nicely, quite satisfying. I like the shimmer formula. It's not the most exciting shimmer formula. It very much reminds me of ColourPop. It's a great formula. It performs really well. It does what I expect it to do. It's not gonna blow anything out of the water, but they're also very clearly shimmers and not just topper shades. I find that I don't really like topper shades. Like if I'm gonna put the time into doing my eyes, I want it to be a statement. And topper shades just don't do that for me. Topper shades are usually, if you don't know what I mean, what I'm referring to is like a very light, not opaque sort of shimmer. The BH Cosmetics Do Not Disturb palette had like two or three topper shades instead of the shimmer formula that I wanted, and I've decided to declutter that palette for that express reason. But these shimmers are what I want in a shimmer. They are pigmented, they're opaque, you get what you expect. Another thing is, in this palette, what you see is what you get. However it looks in the pan is how it's going to translate onto the skin, and I really appreciate that because I have had some palettes in the past where the color does not transfer onto the skin the way that you expect it to, and that can be really frustrating because, first off, don't we buy palettes for the color story? So if you buy a palette and then it looks different when you get it home and you actually put it on your skin, well, that's super annoying. Not to mention, if you plan your looks and you dip into a shade and you're expecting it to be an orange shimmer and it ends up looking more pink, it can totally throw off the rest of your look. Now, maybe you'll get lucky and it still looks nice, but it's not what you planned for, and that can be frustrating too. So these colors have appeared on my skin the way they look in the palette, and I really, really appreciate that. My one criticism, I would say, of this palette is this shade right here, which I used as my very inner corner highlight. This shade I wish were a brighter, more, hi babe, lemony sunshine yellow, something brighter, something less grungy. I would expect this shade to be in more monochromatic green palette, to be paired with olives and mossy greens and brown tones. It would be a nice grungy companion for those sorts of shades, but this palette doesn't actually have any shades like that. It has this shade right here, which is kind of like a golf course grassy green, and then it has this shade here, which is aqua, certainly more blue, especially you can see on the eyes, it's more blue than green. And then it has this teal here, which, yes, is quite a green leaning teal. However, it's got blue undertones. It's a much more jewel toned greeny blue. And so this shade doesn't look bad with them. I mean, again, I used it today because I wanted to stay within this palette, but if I were pairing this with something else, I absolutely would grab a brighter, more vibrant yellow, because I think that that sort of tone would work better with all of these. Like, this shade is gonna look nice with this one and this one, and it looks okay with the blues, but it doesn't look as bright as I would have liked. Aside from that, maybe an inner corner highlight, but I think that this shade here, Wings, is probably going to be quite a nice inner corner highlight for most of these shadows, particularly the blues and purples. You could certainly pair it with the green too. Pink and green look great together. So my one criticism of the palette would be this shade here. I wish it were just a brighter color, even more like this yellow. Like, the packaging itself has a nice, bright, vibrant yellow, which would look good with all the shades inside. But that's not what we got in the yellow shimmer. So that would be my only complaint. Aside from that, I'm very happy. I like the palette a lot. I love the color story. It has performed beautifully, and I really look forward to pairing it with other palettes. So that is everything. I hope you enjoyed the look. Thank you again for hanging out with me. Remember that you can like and subscribe if you want to see more of this sort of content, and you can find me on Instagram at Shimmers and Silver. So until we see each other again, I do hope you have a wonderful day. Bye!